Why not? Shut up, it's never too late. Hello, Mrs. Skinner. Why did you say we're too late?
Maybe if you would have come earlier, I wouldn't have had to kill my wife. What the hell took you so long?
Hey, you know the merchant saw Ace die. Sammy tell you anything about the attack?
I couldn't get much sense out of him about that. All I know is that someone or something attacked him. They spotted him and died. One more thing else, you'll have to get him from Sam.
Do you like snake squeezins?
They are God's greatest gift to his creation. Most delicious thing you've ever tasted. Really takes the edge off, well, everything.
Where can we find Sammy?
If you're lucky, he'll be in real nowhere. That's where he stocks up on snakes before he's around.
Keep hearing about that place, but I can't get there near it. What do you think of the Desert Rangers? You kill the woman out there? What are the mushroom caves? When did the mind start? What kind of sabotage?
Some of the fellas thought somebody might put something in the nutrient base. We headed off with an irrigation shutoff valve and got Larson to turn it off. I can still get across.
What do you know about the pumps? That would make sense that they got infected. Dr. Larson, you are a very interesting character. Why are you hiding?
I can't help it. My son's out there. What's left of him, anyway? I don't want to come upon him suddenly and have to shoot him. Much better if somebody else does it.
What do you know about the valve?
Larson said that closing the pump valve will shut down the irrigation system. Maybe keep the infestation from getting any worse. We've gone way too long.
think someone did this on purpose. What do you think the boy named Sue?
That boy's a strange one, and I don't mean his name. There was a guy named Moonbat once, so Sue don't face me. But all he does is bitch about the way we do things around here.
Oh no. You're very likely an obvious suspect. I mean, he could be onto something, but then again, he could be just saying that because Sue's all about the plants.
If I see him, I'm gonna give him one for Martin and Sergio right between the eyes.
Be right back, guys. Neat bio. Okay, we're back. Let's do this. Now, where were we? Ah, yes. Okay. Clear a path to the lobby. You can escape. Ghosts? What do you mean by ghosts?
What else would you call dead people you knew and loved who are still up and walking around? I killed one already. I don't want to kill no more.
I clear the path. What you talking about? Don't be crazy. Pretty much killed him, man.
Hey, Rangers, you're gonna be heading out. Do you mind me coming with you? Talking to you is making me ashamed of the time you work with me. You know I like you, son. That shouldn't stop me from trying to get moving. See what I can do to help upstairs. Can I follow you? Just tell me to get out from the caves?
Yes, let's do it.
Thank you. I feel better already. Okay, let's go.
Get those points up. Four skills. Perception skills used to allied subjects. No. Perception challenge 1. So, do I really want to do that? Can use precision strikes. Let's go with that. Not mechanical repair, but it's decent. Do we want? Let's go with alarm and. Okay. this. Cut away or blown up. Didn't get anybody with demolition. That's messed up. Do it, can ya? It's 38 cal. 38 caliber. Yet. May have been a mad loose once, but it's been poking around this old woman's memories. I guess good manners are among the many things to die in the Great War. Oh well, since you're here anyway, might as well sit down and read on. I was born in an odd place in a wasteland. Nominally, a time of peace. There were still a few places one could consider safe. My home was a small community, near enough to quartz to benefit from its protection, such as it was. Far enough away to be left alone by its own more anarchic elements. Out there, we couldn't even rely on the rangers or needles, or heck, even the guardians. When trouble hit, we had to fend off for ourselves. I can still remember looking out the window to see my father or my brothers standing guard as the sun set. I think it's just something that those are my fondest memories. And it was a hard life, relatively. But as a child, I thought it was. And life only got harder as I grew up. I suppose one of my main worries back then was being a burden on my family. I taught myself how to shoot a gun, but my brothers would never let me stand guard with them. So my father taught me what little he knew about working the earth. It wasn't enough. Turns out I loved farming. I wanted to learn more than the stubborn old man of my community could teach me. So I left my home in search of knowledge. You learn the hard lessons fast, out on the road. I followed a river up to Needles and thought I'd find a better place to live until learning the town was completely populated by crazies. I hear little has changed since. Vegas was no better, and if not, by my trusty M1911, I didn't know if I would have made it true. Next, in a blatant show of naivety, I headed north into the desert. There isn't much out there. With the kind of luck no one really deserves, I discovered an old abandoned Gizmonic Institute research station. I camped inside the security post, only to be awoken in the middle of the night in a brusque manner. Turns out this research station wasn't as abandoned as it looked. They did not take to me initially, but it was obviously I was not the spy for the Guardians they thought I was. Being discovered by the Guardians was a great fear for the research station, which was sitting on a wealth of pre-war tech and know-how. Once they agreed to like me, they were quite willing to share some of it with me. I should write more about these kind people, considering I spent decades with them. Let's be honest here. I'm writing this as much for it to be found after I die as I am for myself. And they violate their privacy too much for that. Even with the Guardians gone and the fact that it's decades since I was there, better safe than sorry. Years later, with the mind full of new knowledge and ideas, I finally felt ready to go back home. The wastes have no interest in closure or happy endings. Arriving at my old home, I found nothing but black cinders and the bones of old memories. I left as soon as I could, and I've never been back. Headed east then, I found the kind of place I've been looking for all along in the agriculture center in Ivo. Thriving communities in need of my help. This was a time of change in a wasteland. I never called the rangers bad guys, but their story is not one of endless heroism they often present. In my younger years, they were mostly known as useless, if well-meaning fuck-ups, with the occasional bad apple climbing too high up in the ranks. But things changed when Vargas and his team went on patrol, making things better pretty much everywhere they went, and ending so many of the wasteland's problems, including the Guardians, if only by the skin of their teeth. I still don't quite know how they did it, but they did. Sadly, our paths never crossed, or I'd have offered them my help and my gun. Despite the delightful young population of Highpool keeping me occupied for a while, I found my true home at the Agriculture Center. It was a time of rebuilding for them after the old man passed on, him having led the community for most of his existence. My farming experience and scientific know-how were welcomed with open arms, and we started many aggressive research programs to produce even higher yields than the giant plants the agricultural center was already producing. Since then, Hypool has tried with us, and Ranger seems to be doing better off late, so the future looks bright. Then things got a little weird. Fallout from the bombs was changing the wasteland in many ways. The Ag Center was no exception. Kikati tells me that the early farmers could have tried counterintuitive mutations that were affecting the plants with selective breeding. Instead, they decided to ride the wave of weirdness, selecting to look for bigger and hardier mutations to get better yields. Which is how we've come to have tomatoes the size of cantaloupes and cantaloupes the size of beer barrels. I'm cool with it. Sup? Sup, ads? For most of his existence, TX Center was led by an old farmer everybody called the old man. His real name might have been Miguel. He must have been 100 when Vargas Trasher Angela and Hellraiser came a-calling. Fresh-faced and eager to help. How you doing, Az? How's your day been, buddy? Why did the Ag Center need help? Well, mutation is just all roses and giant carrots. Around about that time, the center was invaded by hordes of giant rabbits who were just as happy eating people as they were the crops. It was a serious problem. It was by the attacks being seemingly coordinated by some crazy old coot. Called Harry the Bunny Master. Swear to God, I'm not making this up. You can't make that up, can ya? Okay, that's codes. Who is Matthias? August 10th, fell in with the snake-squeezing sailor from Rail Nomad. Wanted range protection on his way to, I'm gonna say Rail. Nice of him to share his water, but I wish the boring son of a indecipherable or shut up.